Hello, everybody. I have my 5-year Hobonichi with me today. I realize I have not actually featured this Hobonichi in its own video. I've shown it in some other videos that I've done, but I wanted to dedicate a video to this just to show how I have this set up and how I've got it in this particular traveler's notebook cover. I'll go through, you know, what I'm doing with it and a peek in the inside, but it's so, so simple, which is why I've never done a video before, but I did want to show how I managed to get it in this traveler's notebook. So obviously, this is an A6 size. So I have an A6 size traveler's notebook, and this is from Chic Sparrow. It is a Maverick in the golden brown. It's a classic, so there are no pockets on the inside, but I did have the stitching added. And I love this cover so much. I'm so attached to the texture of this and just the pattern of all the cracks on here. And I've tried to use this in a couple of different setups, but I've just never been like all the way happy with how those other setups turned out. So I tried it in here. I tried it with the 5-year inside, and I just really, really love how filled out this is and just how it all came together. It was a lot better than I was expecting. So I definitely want to share that with you, because for the 5-year, I really, really, really did not want to use the strings on the inside of this book at all. I didn't want it in the covers. I didn't want it in the middle of the book with the, you know, really delicate Tomoe River paper. So, you know, it's supposed to last 5 years. And I know because the edge of the covers here, you know, they stick out a little bit more. And I just know that the strings are going to push on that. And there's the potential to rip that on the edge here. And yeah, I just wanted to avoid that. So I immediately decided that I wanted no strings in this at all. So I will open this up and just show you what I have. This is a 4x6 postcard from Annelies Draws on Etsy. I'll link her shop. And so this is just straight writing. As you can see, I do a highlight of the day on this side, and then I just do what I was grateful for on this side. And that's it. It takes like 2 minutes, and I'm really, really enjoying it so far. I started on January 1st, and I've been doing it every day since then, and it's great. I hope to continue it. So I previously had this in the Bloom fabric cover that gift set comes with. And I like it. I think it's absolutely gorgeous, but there's not a clear cover on cover to go on that fabric cover. So I knew that it wasn't gonna, you know, stay pristine for the entire 5-year lifespan of this. So I always knew that I wanted to get some sort of leather cover for it, especially because when spring and summer roll around, we're going to start camping again. And so this, I'm going to take this with me. And I just knew that fabric cover wasn't going to cut it. So the only other option I really had was to get a custom leather cover made. And I just really didn't want to go that route. I didn't want to have to wait for it. I didn't want to have to just cross my fingers and hope that when I got it, it would fit like I wanted. Because if you're familiar with this Hobonichi, it's bigger or it's thicker than, you know, A6 sized notebooks like the regular Hobonichi Techo planner or, you know, an A6 Stylogy. This is just so much thicker than those books. And you know, the cover is a little bit bigger all the way around too, because it has this extra, you know, just this extra amount of cover to it on the edges. So because I love this traveler's notebook so much, I kind of just slipped it in here, and I really, really, really loved the way it filled out this cover. So I was trying to figure out a way to have this secured on the inside of here without having to put these strings anywhere on the inside of this book. And I actually randomly saw a video from Sylvia at Write Your Life, and I will link it in the description, but it was a video that was like over a year old, and she had a traveler's notebook and had just one of the craft folders in it. And what she did was she slipped the front and back cover of an insert into each of the pockets on the folder and just kind of used that. So I just kind of took that idea and it inspired me to do this. So I knew I didn't want to cover the front of this because I really like the way this looks with the Maverick. And when I opened it, I wanted just to see, you know, that it was the 5-year techo. So what I have is the back cover is just slipped into this. And all this is cardstock. And I made this, I kind of like threw it together without any like deep proper measurements. So there's just this flap here, and this is where obviously the string goes. And then it's just this little slip pocket for the back cover of this to go into. And so it's secured on this one string, but none of the tension and wear and tear of this string will be on the actual book. It will be on this cardstock folder. I'm just gonna call it a folder. So because of the thickness of this book, it fits best when this is on the rightmost string of the traveler's notebook, and then it just allows for that spine to fall exactly where it needs to. And oh my gosh, I love this so much. So what I have in here, I just have the pencil board that it came with, and I always need to keep my pens with my setups if at all possible. So I just took the same black cardstock that I used to make this folder. I just cut it to size, and then I have this pack of like 9 pen loops, and I just adhered one to the cardstock here. And what I do is I just kind of find the middle of the book, slip it in there and close it. And the thing is with these thicker notebooks, they tend to have this U shape on the edge here. So I find that the pens just fit really nicely into that U like that. And it just happened to work out so well with it in this cover. It just sits in there so lovely. And this isn't obviously my planner, so I'm not dipping into this throughout the day and when I'm on the go. So I don't need a super secure way to keep my pen. So I'm okay with it just being, you know, on this piece of cardstock just slipped in here like that, because I'm only opening this at the end of the day, jotting down what I need to, and then closing it up. I don't keep this with me at all times. I'm not taking it out of the house. It just stays at home. So this is actually perfect for what I'm using this for. So I know that someone is going to ask me details about how to put this together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make another one of these. And if you want to know kind of how to make this, then stay tuned. Otherwise, yeah, that's my whole setup for this. I told you it's just nothing much. And when I made this, I didn't realize it, but I had picked a poor piece of paper for that. It was sliced here, and I wasn't aware of that. So I'm just going to make a fresh one and see if I can you know, just kind of clean it up a little bit and make a better one for here. So if you're interested in that, then stay tuned. Okay. I'm not super great at making like tutorials for little DIY projects like this. So I apologize if, this is not very great, but I'm going to try to be as thorough as I can. So I just have an 8.5 by 11 sheet of cardstock here. And so when I made this I literally just kind of put this on here like this and didn't take any measurements and just kind of like creased it where I needed to and folded it up. So I took measurements of this and it is 11.7 centimeters across. So it's 11.7 wide and then 15.8 centimeters tall. And that's really the most important measurement. And this is specific to the A6 5-year Hobonichi cover. So with that measurement, and I will put those measurements in the description in case you just need to like take a quick glance at it. But with those exact measurements, this should slip in here just perfectly. And then there's enough width here that the string will fit in there nicely and the traveler's notebook should close exactly where it needs to. So the rest of the measurements, like for the width of this flap here and the width of this, they're not really that important. Like this can be smaller, you can make it a little bit longer, you just want it to be shorter than the 11.7. So you just want it to fall short of it like this. And then this flap, I mean, that could be any width you want it to be here as well. This is just what's going to secure the back cover of the Hobonichi. So the main important measurement is that this is 11.7 across and 15.8 centimeters tall. So what I will do is go ahead and fold for this flap. So I'm just going to mark it with my pen. And what I'm gonna do is just to make sure I'm not like making a line like that way, I wanna make sure it's straight up and down. I'm just gonna use this to help me make sure I'm making a straight line. Okay, so that just helps to score it because this cardstock is really thick. So if I just fold it without scoring it, it tends to not be very crisp. So this will be where the string of the traveler's notebook sits. So I'm just gonna fold it in like this, right? So that's that, like that. So then now I just need to fold this over to make this slip pocket. So I'm just going to measure the 11.7 here and then fold that over. Okay, so I'm just going to use this to score it. All right, so I'm just gonna fold this and there we go. So it's just gonna look like that. So traveler's notebook string will go here and then the Hobonichi back cover will slip in right here. So basically now we're just gonna fold down the edges. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is measure out the 15.8 centimeter height that this needs to be. And I'm just gonna kind of like eyeball it and just kind of get it in the middle here because these ends are just gonna be folded over so they don't have to be like exactly perfect. Like they don't have to be the same size. So let me get my ruler. Okay, so I've got it marked off here and I think, so what I will go ahead and do, I'm going to cut triangles down to those marks so that when I fold each end over, they fold over nicely. Actually, no, I'm not gonna do that yet. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna score this all the way across so that I have that guide. I'm just gonna check it against the book, and I just recommend you do this anyway for any size that you're working with. Just put your book up next to it to make sure that those measurements are as accurate as possible. So let's see. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and cut those triangle notches in the top and the bottom of this. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to cut this top piece off and then this bottom piece off. All right, so we're left with this. So Traveler's Notebook string goes here. And then what we can do now is just flip each of these over to create that slip pocket. So it's gonna go like that. Let me just test my book out in it just to make sure everything is accurate. Oh, that looks perfect. All right, so that looks like it's gonna work out great. So what I will do is I will go ahead and glue down these flaps. Okay, and so that is the gist of it. So what I ended up doing with this one is I just cut out notches on the top and the bottom because I noticed that this is just to accommodate for the size of this book. This is a little bit taller than these strings. So the top and the bottom of the strings are, we're putting a lot of tension on this cardstock. And because, I mean, it's just cardstock. So I ended up cutting those corners out to notch it like this to help alleviate some of that strain. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the same thing here. And there we go. It has notches, and you could use a hole puncher if you need something a little bit nicer and neater. So I'm just gonna try it in here, and that's actually perfect. And then another thing I noticed was these pointy corners. When I have the book in here, let's just go ahead and test this whole thing out. I noticed that the corners just came a little too close to the edge for my liking. So I went ahead and just rounded those out with my scissors as well, because the Hobonichi has rounded corners anyway. So it's just a little extra step. But I did it with, you know, this first one that I made. And you can see when I didn't score it, the edges kind of warp a lot. So this one actually came out so much cleaner when I just scored it with my pen. So I'm going to go ahead and round these corners. And I do have a corner rounder, but this is pretty thick. This is like three layers of cardstock at this corner, and I just know my cheapo corner punch isn't going to handle this well. All right, that looks good enough for me. So let's test this guy out. There we go. And right here, I actually made this one a much closer fit, which I like on that cover. Oh, that's so great. So there we go. It fits really, really awesome in here. Yeah, and you know, this is secure enough for me. If I could just lay this in here and it not move around, I totally would. So I definitely wanted something where it looked like this was just sitting in here and the folder just sort of like disappeared in the back. But you know, you can definitely customize this for your own needs and for your own aesthetic. And I tried to look, I tried to search on YouTube for 5-year Hobonichi in a traveler's notebook to see if anybody else had done something similar where they didn't actually use the strings within the Hobonichi book. I just did a really quick search, but I didn't see any other ideas for this. So if you do something similar to this, please share, please link any other videos that you may know of that show a book being secured in a traveler's notebook like this without having the strings interfere with the actual book. But I am so, so loving this. I hope that this was helpful a little or a lot to you guys. Let me know what you think. And yeah, that's everything from me. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all again soon. Bye.